Hi. I'm here to do my patriotic duty. Please enjoy my show. I think you'll find it quite illuminating. Bye-bye. Street dreamer.
Life. I wonder.
Street dreamer.
Imagine smoking weed in the street without cops harassing. Imagine going to court with no trial. Lifestyle cruising blue Bahama waters. No welfare supporters. More conscious of the way we raise our daughters. Days are shorter, nights are colder. Feeling like life is over. These snakes strike like a cobra. The world's hot, my son got knocked. Evidently, it's elementary. They want us all gone eventually. Trooping out of state for a plate. Knowledge, if coke was cooked without the garbage, we'd all have the top dollars. Imagine everybody flashing. Fashion, designer clothes. Lacing your click up with diamond rolls. Your people holding dough, no parole, no rubbers. Going raw, imagine law with no undercovers. Just some thoughts for the mind. I take a glimpse into time, watch the blimp read, the world is mine.
And I rule the world.
Imagine that.
I free all my sons. I love them, baby. Black diamonds and pearls.
Could it be, if you could be mine, we both shine.
If I rule the world.
Still living for today, in these last days of time. Yo, it'd be paradise life relaxing. Black, Latino, and Anglo-Saxon. Armani exchange the range. Cash, lost tribe of Shabazz. Free at last. Brand new whips to crash. Then we laugh in the iller path. The villa houses for the crew. How we do? Trees for breakfast. Dime sexes have been stretches. So many years of depression make me vision the better living. Type of place to raise kids in. Opening eyes to the lies. History's told foul. But I'm as wise as the old owl. Plus the gold child. Seeing things like I was controlling. Click rolling. Tricking six digits on kicks and still holding. Trips to Paris, I civilize every savage. Give me one shot, I turn trife life to lavish. Political prisoner set free, stress free. No work release, purple M3s and jet skis. Feel the wind breeze in West Indies. I think Coretta Scott King, mayor the cities, and reverse things to willies. It sound foul, but every girl I meet to go downtown. I'd open every cell in Attica, send them to Africa.
If I rule the world,
imagine that.
trouble.
But I'm no crazy.
Yes, we do. Huh. This union thing. Well, everybody knows I'm a real selfish little individual, and I really like myself. And so I'm going to offer the gentleman and the lady an opportunity to see that my book's coming out, and I want y'all to buy it. I had two people so far tell me yesterday that they were going to buy my book. But right now, what I really wanted to impress upon you is the depression, the pain, the loneliness, and how, without a desire, a will, a drive to do nothing but to get revenge on the other, you wanted to tell the marshal when he came to get me to send you, to give me your regards. Well, what did you do when you had all of the information that says that Niger is as crooked as the tips of the Nazi cross? State Senator Huntley, Monica Pringle and Lester News are absolutely terrific for crying out loud. They're so good. But why contain it in your office? It couldn't go to Albany? Because you don't want me to get hold of the information on the federalization and the $500 million tax-free bond issue that went to the rich, and you didn't earmark anything for the people in public housing so that they can have a stake and to get out of public housing. You want them to go to this? You want them to go to this? Is this what you want for them? Well, I was born rich. I've always had everything. I don't need anything, and I don't need anybody. I don't need anything. I'm happy right here. I feel like the seaside goes down. You mean to tell me I got to the point to where Dr. Dreis litigated all the way up to the appellate division of New York State Supreme Court, and everybody says like frozen in time and space. Okay, well, why don't I plead you in a case and let's see if the press will have a little bit more attention they want to pay to me. What about that $5 billion class action lawsuit on behalf of 40,000 people that didn't get an administrative process? Now, I don't know what you've been doing to those guys. I'm a French green card guy. Now, you've been doing what you want to do with them, when you want to do it. You blow smoke up their rear end. Some Haitians, you stick a broomstick up in them. The other ones, you up and bang, 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 bang. You shoot 50, 60 bullets into them. Okay? Let me tell you what you're going to do to me. You're going to give me some respect when you walk to the steps of the courthouse, and I'll put a spanking on you. And when I'm done with you, you're going to go home, and I expect you to just slap your mama for making you so stupid playing with me. That's the satisfaction I get. I live for that. I live for that. That's my only freaking dream. I feed off of it.
There you go.
Hello, everybody. This is Dr. Phil Dreis and Robert Huntley. We're here with two homeless guys, but guess what? We haven't given up. We're not freaking failures. We're people. We're human.
Senator of Shirley Huntley, state senator, New York State Senator Shirley Huntley. Oh, I love my mother, and 113th of a crooked cop motherfucker that ruined my life, and, you know, and a stink pussy fucking bitch, you know, along with that, you know, that pretty much I loved her. She knew that. And I don't see how she cannot help me at this point in my life. Now, my mother has pretty much not turned her full back on me, but has let me have it, you know, really, you know, to a sense that it's my fault that of her health condition, because I drove her into a nervous condition, and that's all bullshit. I love my mother from the bottom of my heart. I love Deputy Inspector Tommy Lawless, who died. Mommy's right-hand friend and PD, and Deputy Inspector Philip Erickson. And, you know, I have let 113th and 103 off the hook with whatever I feel.
Show them the bruises on you.
They have ruined me.
Show the bruises on you got when you went over there and your brother beat you up. This is right here. This is State Senator Huntley's son, Robert Huntley. He was beat up by his brother, who's a New York NYPD, and told not to come back home again. That's betrayal. That's treason. There's no sense for this. That's treason. But we're two homeless guys. We're buddies. And guess what? We're gonna fight the fight.
I've been homeless for the last 20 motherfucking years, where I thought I was like a white, black Jimi Hendrix. you know, where, you know, the guitar on my back and whatnot, but at this point in time, I'm 54 fucking years old, and this is bullshit.
And today's Sunday, September 26th?
Yes, it is.
And it's right now 7:40.
As far as Mayor Bloomberg is concerned, the New York Senate, the Congressional Committee is all full of shit. Because me and this man have legitimate evidence and what have you, and I have sued PD and fucking won. But this is bullshit, goddammit. This is what the fuck it is, you know, goddammit. And, you know, through any righteousness through God that sent his only begotten son down here. Fuck with his denomination, his abomination of making this motherfucker and then turning his goddamn back on it. It's fucking bullshit. Why the hell did his only son begotten son have to come down here and fuck with this? And
now,
be tortured
by goddamn fucking Jews. Before we run out of time, Robert. Now, when I gave you that flyer, you saw your mother's name on it. You called her.
Yes, I did.
And then when you talked to her, and you asked her, was I the guy that supposedly put the death threat or anything crazy like
that?
No,
you were not. No, Ma denied that. It was not Dr. Philip Dreis.
It was somebody else. I have nothing to do with anything like that.
Who had state police and a local 113th cop who held my hand one night. I was going to alcohol withdrawal. Another nice-looking balding cop. Yeah. I talked about like dogs, that precinct. But yeah, they did ruin my fucking life. Along with that stink fucking cunt hoe, Chantel Prasad Dubois. And she is full of shit, you know?
Now, when you spoke to her, did she knew about this case about New York City Housing Authority and all that nonsense with me?
She knew about it. She knew about it 100%, but her aides were handling the case, at which point they did not let my mother in on what's happening.
And now
she's trapped. They intercepted this man's legitimate interfucking-mation by through aid, you know, like all politicians go. Not all politicians get their mails read and received by aides and do whatever the fuck they want with it. God damn it. Just my fucking ass.
Brother, we done here, man. I'm going to go ahead and go to my mom's house in Howard Beach, and my mom going to give me some money. I got my bedroll right here. Everybody can see. This is the bedroll. This is what I sleep on. Robert, I swear to God, I got another.
I want
to
bring that up on the internet.
It's on the flyer I gave you. I got another one to give you. Here, take another flyer, but I can show you. We can sleep on the beach. I got another sleeping bag. I help you. Here, it's right here on the internet. Right here on this flyer, right here, brother. The way you was talking about so good about your mother until I heard her and until you and her started talking, that's not nice. Come on, man. The guy needs help. I was a drug and alcohol counselor. Jesus Christ. This guy needs help, folks.
Right. So, I am right. I like to know that it's boring being freaking right all the time, people. It's boring. But that's my job. I love it. And here's Floyd Flick himself. Lord have mercy. Brother Flake, how you doing?
Wonderful. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
I see.
You remember me?
Are you really a golfer? Or you
yes, I'm really a golfer.
No, okay. All right.
You remember me?
I'm going to learn. No, not right away.
You never heard of me?
I don't know.
Philip Dreis? Dr. Philip Dreis?
Yeah, what you doing? What you doing?
I'm trying to destroy the Black Mafia in South Beach Place.
How you doing?
Well, I'm homeless. They took $100,000 stuff out of my home.
Who
my
did?
Business. Through that incapacitated hearing, I took all of the evidence of Congressman Meeks that said, Huntley, you give me your email, I'll send you the evidence. Because everybody seemed to think you're the head of the Black Mafia in South Beach Queens.
Think who is?
They think you're the head man that you're supposed to be. Who do you think put all them posters out here when Bloomberg came to see you? I did.
Oh, I
ambushed them.
Oh,
right in front of your place. That's my job.
No,
because the scoop came out of Leroy Comrie's office with Wayne Huff getting his itinerary and giving it to Rashida that sent me out to ambush Bloomberg. Now I'm out in the street as a homeless guy. So I've been retaliating. I'm the one that exposed Shirley Huntley.
Huh?
I'm the guy that exposed Shirley Huntley.
No, she needed exposure.
What? I'm not done.
I told Malcolm a long time ago.
Well, the rumor was since Malcolm got busted, you went in, you got sequestered at the, like you're some kind of pope.
Let me tell you something. I will tell you the truth because that's my job. That's my job to be a journalist and to actually get the news from, because I will talk according to what my sources tell me. But when I run into the man, I got to ask the man.
You got to do it.
Because then I got to get back on my blog and tell people, look, I was wrong about Reverend Flake and everything they told me that I was blasting all over the internet. Mm-hmm. I got to suck it back. And this is the first time Dr. Dreis is going to have to suck something back. What? I'm not as forgiving as you. It ain't my job to be a preacher and give absolution. I'm a Catholic. Are you kidding me? Reverend Flake. Reverend Flake. Uh-huh. You know I'm the guy that did it, right?
You did what?
Get Shirley Huntley and get all these guys in trouble. It's my job. It's fine. You haven't heard about me? How much of a bad guy I was?
I didn't know you were involved in it at all.
I'm the guy, remember, when I had that business I wanted to start up there that cleaned up the parking lot for you over there.
Okay.
All right, I'm that guy. I'm the still guy that's a community contributor who doesn't ask for anything. And then the Bloomberg administration, I can prove to you. How big do you think it is for Mayor Bloomberg to send a marshal with his personal regards at my eviction?
What?
If I can prove that to you by giving you the marshal's name and you call him and he did that, will you help me? And then if I give you the videotape of Shirley Huntley's son and what he said that I said to the Attorney General, what Ida Smith said that night, just conducting a form of redlining, but this is federal redlining because Congress is the bank, HUD is the bank, NYCHA. And yeah. That there's not one engine or TP, you're a congressman, you know that the appropriations bill that funds NYCHA is it's on Indian reservation.
That's right.
Well then,
yeah.
They think I'm some kind of freaking moron.
Yeah, well, they do that when you do something different. When I went and did the bill for the getting people out of public housing and trying to move them into housing.
That's what I'm talking about. When was the federalization?
It was a
$500 million, $500 million deal. What you had to do was earmark some of that money for them to buy the bonds in order to buy themselves out of public housing.
David Dinkins, your dumbass mayor at the time, did not understand what I was doing.
So you know why I'm hunting Negro right now? I call myself a new black slave.
Without due respect.
What? What do you think I'm doing? I'm a Haitian that was born free somewhere else.
Yeah,
I'm an elected president of my country and they tried to tell me I was crazy. How do you think I noticed and got this?
He didn't know.
Because public housing is not sustainable.
It's not sustainable. I'm with you. I agree.
And I never asked to be in public housing. I inherited the apartment.
Read the Hope 6 legislation by Floyd Flake.
Okay.
And you'll see what happened. So Chicago bought into
it. You got a special number for me?
I don't
so that I can call you and talk to you? Because then they'll never let me go.
But Chicago tore down some...
Yeah, I know. I saw that. I saw the demolition on
the... Milwaukee tore them down, and so people could have home ownership.
Let me tell you,
Let
me tell you what 3.5 years.
But my fight, you have to understand one thing about me.
What's that, sir?
My biggest fight for the last 38 years has been against these nigger politicians who don't understand economics, don't understand how to build community. Charlie Rangel ain't put nothing up in Harlem.
I just want you what about James Sanders? He's got a legislative council that's going to sit there and listen to every freaking lobbyist that walked up to his ass, hand him the freaking piece of paper, and Sanders going to hand it in as his freaking bill and try to take credit for it.
Really?
When I tried to get to the chief of staff, look, when they hear Dr. Dreis, everybody gets scared for some reason because they know I'm out the bus step. All right? And guess what? I was walking by here hoping I could bust you, and then guess what? Everything's vindicated. I was wrong about you.
Well, man, you know I'm about this community. That's all.
But Reverend Flake.
That's why I left them.
You know what I'm going to do?
See, you know what they do? They get elected. Think this is a lifetime job. Not one of my elected officials in this community has any concept of economics.
I know.
You know? So they so the local preachers get pissed off because I build homes and build houses.
Hey, well, everybody hates you
and
for
all that.
I mean, everybody hates.
But I'm saying, and I don't get upset about
it at all. What do you got to say about this whole thing about you wanted that casino? They called it a gambling
picture. Well, here's
I'm a journalist.
Let me tell you what happened on that. That whole casino piece I did not invite myself in.
Uh-oh.
They invited me.
Who's they?
Those, the white the developers.
Oh, in other words, they trusted you. The white folks said, we got us somebody over here that can represent his people in his community, and because of your influence here,
because
they wasn't going to diss you.
That's correct. That's
so
correct.
It ain't so about you, some gambling you wanted, some casino for fund the church as a nonprofit.
No, it wasn't coming to the church at all. You know what I was supposed to do?
They got all spokesman?
That. No, they got all that vacant land.
Uh-huh.
They came to me and said, Reverend, you have built more homes in this community than anybody. What we want to do is take some of the vacant land and build houses on. So what we want to do...
They came to you as a developer?
They came to me as a partner to come in and help build the homes.
How come this ain't in the newspapers, my
well,
friend?
Well, there ain't nobody going to write that.
Why? The
because
same way they're not going to write that Mayor Bloomberg is eliminating your congressman, you should know that.
Objective.
Now, what if during the Clinton administration, Andrew Cuomo ceded his position to be governor to the Clinton elimination of welfare by realizing that housing would become full. New York City is the biggest one. It would become full. Yeah, it wouldn't be sustainable.
Mm-hmm.
What if you put a poison plan, poison pill in the plan so that Mayor Bloomberg can come here, appoint some affirmative action chairman to put the shock and awe on Negro and the mulatto establishment that's the next tier up, then the bottom layer, and then he influences the federal policy writers to raise the bar to retention to a whole bunch of disqualifiers that keep you from getting the administrative process. That's a freaking crime.
That's what happened.
What do you mean?
I've witnessed it.
That's what Bloomberg doing now, and everybody trying to play me for crazy.
But it ain't just Bloomberg.
But
the other part of that is, even though we can blame them for all of that, you got to blame these niggas.
What do you think I'm saying? I got the worst reality TV show. Put them niggas back in the slavery.
You tell me
by taking away their economy.
Tell me one thing that's been built.
Nothing.
By any of these
Negro.
Other
problems. Go on Jamaica Avenue. Niggas own shit. Not going on nothing.
Yeah, ain't got nothing.
Ain't got nothing.
Carlisle gets it all.
Man, I was listening to the God, boy.
Yeah, Carlisle gets it
people
all.
People should know
he's from Alabama.
That you ain't the freaking black N-word traitor to your conquered race and stasis. It was insane about you.
Well, it doesn't matter to me. All I know is the state says that Flake has put $600 million worth of development in his community.
So that's why they ain't messing
with
you because you pay your taxes?
So what does it... No, it ain't my taxes. I do it under my nonprofits, church-related. Okay?
Because you know it was in the paper about that garage and your partner was Congressman Mix, and it said you owed millions.
I ain't never been put in the press.
So somebody should correct
money.
That.
I don't owe money to nobody. Nobody.
So you don't misuse nonprofits and all that, because that's what these guys getting busted doing.
Yeah.
But they set up church center up and showed me the business cards.
To build my community and buy this land when it's vacant,
because
I think vacant land gives the community a sense that it's not together. It's
okay.
Not going.
I'm about to get you a HUD bash voucher.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
How about a studio? You got studios in your place?
Oh,
I can say I know the
I'm
man.
Full. All my buildings are full.
All right. No problem. I got other resources. My thing, because you provide the proper services and give them a standard of living, that doesn't have them crawling back to the ghetto where they came from.
Yeah.
So you're building people.
Yeah,
well, you need to say that then.
You're
building communities. Why are they smart enough to understand that?
Huh?
Why are they smart enough to understand building communities means you're actually uplifting the people by making sure that when they get into your place, you don't let them crawl back to the whole nigga dumb bullshit.
But ain't but one of them that's elected know how to do that.
Who's that?
And that's Malcolm. But he got too ambitious.
What do you mean too ambitious? I'm the one that set him up.
Yeah, you got too
ambitious.
You set him up, maybe, but you could do it because his own darn I sat with him.
I got mad when they made him head of economic development. I said, that boy be selling houses. He don't own, gave a house to the Haitians and doing all this stuff purely political because he betrayed me because he wouldn't help me. Yeah. That guy Ken told me I didn't know racism and I didn't know anything. I got a freaking law degree, Jesus Christ. Yeah. I don't care how I'm talking. I ain't gone.
Yeah.
And my sense, international law, because I wanted to go sue my country for the stuff they took from us.
Right. Go to my office over here. I love you, brother. So if you hear Dr. Dryce again, Philip Dryce. And you just put your stuff online. Is that what you do?
Yes, sir.
I see.
Okay. All right, brother. Thank you. Bye bye.
It's a beautiful day in America. Bye bye. He knows we put it online. Bye bye.
Supper monologue, December 12, 2010. I'm going to call Ida Smith at the office of Congressman Meeks to find out what's going on here.
Good morning.
Good morning, Ms. Hart. May I speak to Ida, please?
Please hold on.
Thank you. Hello, Ida. How you doing?
I'm not sure. How are you?
I'm doing all right.
Something's wrong with your voice. What's wrong?
That walking pneumonia I had.
Oh, my God. It came back?
No, it never went away. I'm still being taken care of by Aza.
Okay.
Now, Ida, I got a big problem. Ida? Why can't y'all put on a piece of paper Natchez conducting a formal redlining? Why is my stuff missing? What's going on?
What stuff is missing?
The two books I gave you to the White House. I spoke to Kim Fuller this morning.
Well, she doesn't have them.
Who has them?
You have them. You told me yourself.
I didn't take them.
You did take them. You told me, well, they're not going to D.C. I need to keep them. And I said, fine.
That's not what we said Friday.
No, we said Friday. I said, if Kim doesn't have them, then you have them. Because I gave her something that she carried back. Hold on a second. Hold on.
Yes, ma'am.
Listen,
Ida. I spoke to her already. I don't want to.
What did she say?
She said she got one book that I addressed to the Justice Department. Yeah. I never sent anything to the Justice Department. There were only two books for the White House and the White House only.
Well, then she took it upon herself to give it to the Justice Department because I know that when she was here, I gave her something and I told you that, I remember telling you that
so, the White House... So she took it upon herself to give it to the Justice Department, Ida? How you say... Ida, these people destroyed my life.
No,
these people hurt me.
You have to bear in mind this protocol. Okay. We don't send anything
I do. I did, and look at what I got. What y'all did didn't get me nothing. You've been watching me for years. You've been watching me for years. You know I'm not crazy, and you know what I got. If it ever gets exposed, everybody's screwed.
I haven't exposed anything.
That's what the problem is. I needed you to.
No, I could not do what I was told I could.
Oh, you would, okay.
Okay.
Mommy, you know what? I was right about you.
Excuse
and
me?
I told you
from the jump what was going to happen. I told you that they were not going to read it. And that's why you took the other one.
If I got them, okay. But anyway, the exact same thing are the court papers for my appellate court case, so it's not lost. I just wanted your copy so that I can show that I submitted this, that it was supposed to be for the White House, and it never was sent there to your office, and it was your superior that contained it. That's obstruction of justice.
No, it isn't, because you could have sent it yourself, and you didn't want to.
Because with the evidence that you got, that you read, and you concluded that Natchez conducting a form of redlining, only you can say that, not me.
Well, I said I agreed with you. It was a form of it.
Okay.
And Ida. Don't say that I said that because I didn't say it.
All right. Then
you did what you did anyway.
Then what it's to say is that the Office of Congressman Meeks agrees with the evidence, which is what we said from the beginning, that from the look of the evidence, not what I said, it's what the evidence says. NYCHA is conducting a form of redlining.
No, we've always agreed to that the evidence speaks for itself.
Right. Well, then somebody's supposed to do something after I lost all this, Ida. After I lost all this, don't you want to help me get my money? That's the only way I'm going to get a pretty woman.
You have enough brains and wherewithal. You don't need a pretty woman. You're going to do what you know you have to do. That's not a prerequisite.
God.
And you know that's a fact. And you know that's not what you're about.
Well, guess what? Mother is courting a woman for me, giving me things to take to this woman that's got two kids. She just got a brand new baby. The boy, I met the guy, and I was telling him I'm giving this kid a college scholarship because I pay like $40 a month, and he gets at least a 2-year degree, and all that. And then she tell me she ain't with, and I mean she gorgeous. I love them kids, but I'm tired of getting a woman through loving their kids. I've been through that already, raising people. Why do you think when I get mad, I say all the bad things I say?
Well, you can blame whatever you want, but it's all coming from your mind. So anything you say, I'm not going to believe.
How do I regain all the money, all the time, everything I lost?
Well, what happened to the AquaTube campaign?
AquaTube is right here. I got it out.
Then why aren't you doing it?
I need money from all of my losses in order to kick this off. I need $70,000 just for the radio commercials. I need another $30,000 to give to them down. I need at least $150,000. I spent close to $400 already.
Because you had contracts.
I have a contract which is an allotment contract. I've got to spend all of the advertising dollars in order to generate what I need to make it a contract is something that two people provide.
So you're suggesting that your pursuit of the Ninth Web is going to pay for that?
My pursuit of this cause for black people's rights, that all the black politicians did all everything they could to help the city destroy my life.
I don't believe that, and you don't believe that.
Yes, I do, Ida. Ida. No, listen to me, Ida. When the office of the congressman got evidence that something is so egregious has occurred, and that the president's office responds to the Justice Department with and the letter showing,
and that's exactly why she sent it to the Justice Department.
Where was I supposed to? I wasn't supposed to know what she sent, when she sent it, how she sent it, what's going on, so that it'd be consistent. Okay, then I need a response letter. She was telling me, since my stuff was so garbage and disoriented, they don't respond to that.
Excuse me. They've moved offices twice. And you know what it's like to move your house? It's worse when you're moving an office.
Okay. Guess what? That's why the letter from the VA, I used that as my own excuse not to file litigation on anybody like I was threatening and all that stuff, because we need to get this together, please. But I'm going on vacation. I'm done. After talking to you.
I'm trying to find your white book. If she says she has one, I know you have the other because I didn't want it here.
Okay, guess what? Now you know. Now I know how important it was. Look, right now,
that's not it. That is not it.
What?
What it is that I told you that they weren't going to read it.
Okay.
You said if that's the case, then I need to hold on. I said fine, and then something else happened, and you needed it anyway.
Right now.
You don't remember that?
No, ma'am. But that's okay. I got the duplicate in the court moving papers in appellate division. It's going to cost $300 to get it. That's all. Nothing else. But I just needed that one because since you had it, I wanted to show that I did my due diligence to bring this forward. I got a book coming out. I got to prove everything I say.
Well, you have enough documentation to prove everything you say. I've always told you that.
All right, now I'm selling that story. But then, now, what about this whole situation with... It goes back all the way to the Attorney General, which is now the governor-elect, unleashing NYCHA and untying their hands with no oversight for them to write policies that is eliminating people because of the Clinton administration welfare elimination program. This is crazy. This can get me killed. The things I'm saying. And the evidence points to it. What do you want me to do now? Get out with my life. That's what I gotta do.
Get on, not out.
Oh, get on with my life. Well, yes. Well, I don't know. I think I'm gonna go hit on this young girl half my age with two kids and a brand new born baby. As a matter of fact, you can see the baby on the internet now. That's my new show. And Kim told me to stop.
You have so much in your life that you can be happy about every day. And why you
can't? I can't let them get away with this. All right, let me go get me a woman. Listen, I got a story for you. This is the story. I'm going to Florida to meet up with the Cuban mermaid colony who meet every 10 years to mate. But what they do first is there's seven sisters from the seven seas that end up meeting up on Cuba Island to rest, go to Haiti to eat, and then beach themselves and turn into regular women on Miami Beach, and the guy that's lucky enough to be standing there as a homeless guy on the beach gets to mate with the seven sisters, but the irony is he ends up dying a lonely life because after that, no other women will do.
That's what you want to do?
No, it's a myth I just created. It's part of me entertaining storytelling.
it's a story, but it's not one that I want to live.
No, it's the Lonely Hearts Club guy story.
I know, I got that
part. Of a myth. Yeah, that's all. I'm going to Florida. I'm going to go check out some Cuban babes. That's what I'm going to do. Hang out with my relatives and put on videotape all their stories of my family and where I come from, who my people are.
Whatever happened in Haiti? Who's the new president?
I don't know. I don't care. Look, my people are suffering in such a state, I should be angry. Well, I don't want to think about it. I want to be as willfully blind as the officers of Malcolm Smith, Vivian Cook, Shirley Huntley, and Malcolm Smith that aided the New York City municipality to destroy my life, destroy my business.
I don't know how you think they did that.
By not saying nothing. Just like your office ain't, like what? They ain't never going to say they're not going to do it, they're not going to do it. Then what is he in the office for? Why is he getting money? Why do people have these jobs? As a massage effect. That's crazy.
How do I reach you?
My regular number, the cell phone.
Up until Friday or even after Friday?
Every day. Every day. My stuff is always on. $50 a month.
Okay.
All right.
I will talk to you later.
Thank you, my dear. Happy holidays to you. And I'm sorry. Okay.
All right.
Thank you. Bye-bye. You got it? You got it now? Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. Y'all have a nice day. Bye-bye. What can I tell you? I'm real good at what I do. Damn. Bye.
Speaker number four, Philip Price, please come forward.
Chairman,
like to thank you and I congratulate you.
Thank you.
You are the most articulate and the most charming chairman of the four chairmen that I've known. Ladies, isn't he a good-looking guy? Just a good-looking guy. Okay? Now, we're going to be real nice to Mr. Rhea.
Did my mother pay you to say that?
No. This guy did, the housing whistleblower.
Okay, all right.
I'm that guy.
All right.
Mr. Chairman, I spoke to Constance Robitaille. Mm-hmm. This retaliation against me to destroy my life, can it please stop? I'm a remaining family member. Right now, I've been beating up Byron Metakakis in Supreme Court so bad, this is for you. I just beat him up that
fast. Yeah, okay. So. Okay. You should move to the next one.
Mr. Chairman, I have 1 minute and 40 seconds. Three things. Number one, the retaliation against the whistleblower. If an old lady is embezzled by an employee out of $20,858, Ricardo Elias Morales calls my boss, who I work for at a law firm, and tell me to tell them to leave alone. I left them alone, but you don't leave the old lady in your apartment with the gas stove on for 4 hours, and then you orchestrate a retaliation scheme against me with a containment apparatus that destroyed my life, cost my business over $4.5 million, $100,000 for antiques taken out of my home. I'm a Haitian French Orthodox Roman Catholic. I leave people alone. I don't bother anybody. But the kind of compassion that it takes to see what I'm seeing is just humane. It's nothing special. Another thing, criminal neglect. I don't understand this. You mean to tell me you got two lawyers in two different courts and both of them have a different story about an supposed exclusive senior development that is not? Another one. When you deceive the judges, you deceive the courts, and I bring that to you. The Veterans Administration asked Congress to speak to call in state and federal law enforcement. Ida Smith says, you even got a call recently about May Keys, where they said NYCHA is conducting a form of redlining. Those 21 developments, I believe, were part of the Davis versus NYCHA, that it was found that NYCHA was conducting a form of redlining. Are we still on the same page here? And I'm done.
Mr. Price, we'll have somebody come over and speak to you. Okay, specific to your concerns. Speaker number five, Carmen Quinones.
Hi, how are you?
Mike's coming.
But I am from Douglas Houses. First, I want to tell you, welcome.
Thank you.
I'm sorry that you're getting beat up, but NYCHA has done so much to people that we don't know who to believe anymore, which is sad. I want to tell you that, though, Gloria, hi, because you have always been very helpful to me. And Margarita Lopez, always there, presente. But what I want to tell you is that there are so many things wrong that people don't want to believe anything. Mm-hmm. That's where we're at here. I think that your presentation, beautiful. But even to get here, I couldn't even get down because my elevator was broke.
It's 8:00 at night. I'm at Highland Care Nursing Home. I came to say goodbye to Mrs. Green, because by the time they figure out how I did all this videotaping of people being neglected, warehoused in here, I'll never be let back in here. But if you die before I do, tell God not to forgive Congressman Meeks, not to forgive New York State Senator Huntley, not to forgive New York State Senator Malcolm Smith. Vivian Cook has cancer. She's going to die real soon, 5 years, whatever it is. She should live very long.
so she can suffer a long time. New York City Councilman Leroy Comrie, he rants her for an abomination. This is Sunday night, 8 o'clock at night, and these are the people. Look at this. Look at that. Look at that. And she's right there. That's Mrs. Green. Hooked up to a machine. Being fed these liquid supplements. And this is the warehousing of these old people for $140,000 a year. I can't. Mrs. Green. The reason why my life got destroyed was because I saved your life. I protected you about the $20,848,000 left by Hosea Mitchell, who lives in apartment 10K at Shelton House, New York City Housing Authority. Somebody help me out here, man. My life's been destroyed. Everything. You hear these people yelling in here? This is the woman that was thought to be dead. She's not dead. She's not dead. She's right here. She's right here at Highland Care, and that's her roommate, okay? She is not dead. Mrs. Green did not die. I've been coming here for years. I kept a secret. I knew all this. I told everybody where she was, but they covered it up. The district attorney's office, Creedmoor Psychiatric, Human Resource Administration, Adult Protective Services. Everybody covered this up. And the district attorney knows because I charmed Bianca into giving her the thing to go to my website, and the DA calling me, wanting me to come in there so they can arrest me and abuse me. Not going to happen. They come and get me, they can come and get me. But you better have a search warrant, you better have an arrest warrant. That's all I know. This is the victim of a Nazi copycat crime that Mayor Michael R. Bloomberg covered up. What can I tell you? This is what they look like when they're in a nursing home, dying, and they're just an economy being warehoused because they put them out of their house in public housing so they can harvest the apartments, and they dump them in a nursing home. And when they go to the hospital visiting nurse service, social workers get money when they refer them to certain nursing homes. Go ahead. He can vomit and choke on his own puke. He vomits, he chokes, and dies on his own puke. That's what I'm talking about. He vomits and chokes on his own puke. When's that going to happen? Go ahead. Go ahead. That's what I expose in order to get people to do their damn job. That's what I expose in order to get people to do their damn job. I'll never see these people again in life because I am the housing. Thank you.
my white boy right here on the 161st Street, across from the barbershop. Bro, I've been giving cigarettes away to black people in the neighborhood since I got here. That's the last one I got. I can't give you no more. White boy, what is this? I'm not filming you. Just put your voice on. Because, no.
I don't want nothing to do with
you. No, all right then, what?
Don't film me. I don't want to be on YouTube.
You don't want to be on YouTube. Do you look like you're on YouTube?
Can I just say...
Does it look like you're on YouTube?
Can I just say, Dreis, we thought you were dead. That's it.
Oh, fuck that. Cut the fucking with the politicians.
Yeah, we thought...
What?
Yeah.
They nobody said... Do you see yourself there?
We thought the man got you, that guy.
Them motherfuckers tried to kill my black ass.
Obama gonna come here and shoot your ass.
Put that away.
All right, put it away.
We thought the man got you, Dreis.
The fuck.